that's it.
During these uncertain times, what we're looking for is those that have the courage to take the leap into the unknown.
In this series, an elite team of ex-Special Forces soldiers...
Get up, number 21!
Yeah! ..are putting 21 men and women...
Come on! They're going to kill the hostage!
..through the most grueling stages of SAS selection.
Whatever's happening in the world, we need to switch on. Because the enemy are not going to stop it. If you're scared or exhausted, you need to know that you've got the inner strength to keep fighting.
Each task based on the real process. The recruits must go beyond the physical.
Get in the room!
To come face to face.
What would you do?
Kill, sir!
With their true self.
Go, 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 go.
In the Special Forces, you swear an oath to your comrades. You're willing to give the ultimate sacrifice to see them live another day.
No other test asks as much.
Holly, wake up.
Or means as much.
Every single task seems like they're trying to kill us.
To the few who make it through.
You're about to be in a whole world of pain.
I feel like if I spend any more energy, like, I'm just gonna fall asleep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I've just got so delirious that I told the end of this day. Oh, I can't wait to get home to my missus.
Yeah?
I miss her so much. Oh, I'll never shout at her again.
It's the penultimate phase of the course, with less than 48 hours to go.
Shit, I've learnt more here than I have in my, like, 18 years of existence.
This morning, number 14, Jamie, and number 12, Rhian, handed in their armbands.
Save himself a good kick in anyway.
Yeah.
Now, just 8 recruits remain.
5 minutes outside! Move it!
Sean, you best get ready, we need to go.
Yeah, sure, man, we've got 4 minutes.
2 minutes.
Everyone outside now!
Today is going to be your hardest day. All of you, you are going to need each other. And that's why I'm going to be putting you in teams. Number 3, come out here, stand there. You are team leader, team alpha, is that understood?
Yes, staff.
Number 4, 2 meters behind her, you are team leader, team bravo.
Staff.
Number 3, turn around and pick someone.
Number 7, staff.
Number 7, you are team alpha. Number 4, turn around, pick someone.
Number 9, staff.
Number 9, in you go.
Number 10, staff.
Number 10, let's go, move.
16, staff.
Number 18, staff.
Number 18, let's go.
Number 19, staff.
Number 19, let's go.
Number 4, Sean, has chosen an all-male team. And number 3, Justine, has chosen the remaining female recruits, plus number 10, Kieran.
Team Alpha, Team Bravo, you've got each other now. More of you to rely on, however, more of you to let each other down. Do not be that person.
Yes, sir.
When I say go, you disappear into the accommodation, jackets on, with your Bergens on. Stand by. Go. Move! Move! Let's go!
Throughout this phase, the recruits will be working in their 2 teams.
Within a team, there can be a lot of people that hide behind other people's strengths. But when you're in operations, you have to pull your own weight. You have to be self-sufficient.
Team Alpha in one wagon, Team Bravo in the next. Move! Go!
followership is just as important as leadership. We want a group of individuals that can work as a team.
Forget about the pain now, forget about everything else. All that matters is we win. See where it gets real now, boys. Come on.
Yeah, boy.
If you can't lead a team, not only are you a danger to yourself, but you're a burden to the team.
Yes, go!
Stop moving!
Straight in, number nine, move! Hurry up!
The recruits have been taken to the Rasay peat bogs.
Go, number 19! Move! Go! Move! Go! Go!
To face a test of teamwork and leadership in one of the course's most demanding tasks.
Faster, number 19! Move! Let's go! Go!
I am a non-teaching head of year in a school.
Move.
Responsible for the safeguarding and the general welfare of over 240 students. And there's a lot from disadvantaged backgrounds. I really feel I'm relatable because of the experiences I had growing up.
Straight line, shoulder to shoulder. Fucking switch on. I've fucking gone to a bag of shit. Right. Murder ball. It's all about strength of mind, strength of body, as individuals, which then plays into a strong team. Right. Team Alpha, you will go that end. Team Bravo, you'll go that end. You'll drop your Bergens. The Bergens will basically be your goal line.
Move, let's go! Move, 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 move!
The teams must fight for possession of the tyre. To score, they must drive it across the opposing team's goal line.
This is where it really fucking counts now. All over to you now.
This task is a chance for number four, Sean, and number three, Justine, the youngest recruit on the course, to display their leadership skills to the DS.
I was in Army Cadets for 5 years, in which you're really forced into leadership roles.
Get this fucking tyre over their line.
As a child, I was always like the badass. But being the youngest recruit is, it's definitely scary. So.
Good, number nine, one back. Great communication, great teamwork.
Sean's team win the first round.
Number three, get a grip of your team, otherwise I'll come over there and get a fucking grip of you, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
16, nine, all you four.
Come on, guys.
They all run to the tyre, so drag them all in and then make a run.
Go! Go, move! Move! Get in there!
Go, go, go!
Ah, ha, ha! Classic! Good effort, you two. Well done, number nine.
That tyre was closer to you. You're fucking fannying around.
Come on, guys, we're gonna be getting tired.
You haven't got the strength on your side, but you know what we've got? Speed, agility, mindset. You should be pissing all over these lumps. You're smarter than this. We're a thinking soldier for a reason. It's not about brute strength all the time. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Fucking make it happen.
Yes, sir.
Justine's team are now two rounds down.
I think my greatest weakness is actually showing weakness.
Number three, number 18.
I don't know where that comes from, but I've always hated showing any form of vulnerability.
Treat it like a fucking hot potato. Do not keep hold of that thing.
No, I know, but I think we have an advantage.
Hot potato, girls, hot potato.
Boom! 18. Here we go, let's go!
Here, here!
Go!
Hot potato! Drop it off!
What are you doing?
What was that?
Go!
Stop fucking floundering. Got it! And you sort this lot out.
Yes, sir.
Are you keeping hold of it? For far too long.
You're only as strong as your weakest link, and there's going to be some points when it does take a team to get over things.
Guys, we need to get their arms.
Fuck their arms, just get rid of the thing when it's in your hands.
Guys, we need to do what she says.
I'm the sort of person that has an ability, if I'm in a great mood, to lift people up and lift a whole room up. Because I 100% believe that I give everything I've got.
Number three, over to you. This is where it counts, we go again. Let's go!
Keith!
After just 10 minutes, the all-male team Bravo are now three rounds up against Justine's team.
Good, number 19, good. Good effort, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Let's fucking get amongst it.
Stop! Well done, good effort. Grab your Bergens and you'll be back in this location.
After a draw in the final round, the DS call time on the task, and Team Bravo are the winners.
Listen in. You are only as strong as your weakest member. See how important it is, teamwork. When I say go, you'll make your way as a team to the DS. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Stand by. Go. Let's get out of here. Let's shift. Move!
Wow. Not for the weakest course, is it? Fucking beast mode.
Everybody all right? This is the hardest day.
It's never been this,
my life.
I've never been this wet.
No.
After they were dominated by Bravo in the earlier task, the DS are meeting to discuss the future of Team Alpha.
First thing in the morning, murder ball.
Yeah.
Foxy, over to you and brother.
Two teams, Alpha and Bravo, tough morning. But Team Bravo used their brains a little bit more than the others and sort of thought about what they needed to do and actually good communication. Four asked to step up to the plate. He did well. It, size and speed on his side. But Team Alpha were pretty abysmal. Bag of shit from the off. And it just went from there. Three, I'd say that was her weakest performance to date. She fell off the fucking pedestal big time.
She wasn't in the game this morning. She was just,
yeah,
boom, she wasn't even switching
paying
on to
no
it.
Paying no attention.
Paying no attention. Yeah.
I thought extra responsibility as well on top. It's just fucking the pressure. Kind of imploding.
Listen, she's only young, but that's what selection is all about. And, you know, you imagine that on the battlefield, having a brain fart like that, you know, it's going to cost lives. Number three, in my eyes, is that close. Mm. And she's gone.
God, I'm gonna get the shits. I've had two things of coffee.
That's strange, isn't it?
Do you not?
No, no.
Oh, lucky.
I didn't know that. Because some people can't deal with protein powder, can they?
Oh my God, protein farts are like a different.
My body must be immune to it because I've got.
Really?
Yeah.
Number three, let's go. Pass your best tins to number 18.
After a display of poor leadership on the task, the DS want to find out if number three, Justine, has the potential to take control of her emotions and her team.
Tired.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I think that's one of the hardest times I've pushed myself.
I'll be honest, you know, between us speaking to each other and the DS, you're out the front physically,
mm-hmm.
but mentally, there was a lack of confidence in your leadership ability. How do you feel about leadership and stepping up?
even though I'm quite quiet, when I do try my best to step up to leadership roles.
Unfortunately, it's not getting easier. And that's why we put you under pressure today.
But you were pretty disappointing.
Why did you come on here? What did you want to achieve for you personally?
Because I really want to join the military. I want to join the army. I thought this would be a good test. I've got good discipline. I've always had it ever since I was a child.
Which part of being a child?
Well, my parents are quite high achievers, so I've always felt the need to really, really impress them. My mum went to the Bolshoi Ballet School.
Wow.
And Dad, he's a very entrepreneurial man. And I've always felt like a massive disappointment, so.
Your parents are quite strict?
My mum used to be very strict. We lived in Italy, I was brought up in Italy. Then at 13, my mum passed away. And then that same year, we moved to Cornwall. That was a massive change, obviously.
For me, losing my mum at 11, I wasn't very emotional. I repressed everything, didn't deal with that emotion. And I see that look in your eyes. It reminds me of myself when I was your age.
I did the same thing. And I think I've always had that gap. That's why I joined cadets, because I wanted to feel like I belonged to something. That's also why I kind of wanted to join the military. I want to be like you guys. I want to feel like I'm, you know, part of a family.
You have got the capacity to do this. We've asked you to step up as a team leader. That will continue, but there's times when you've just got to be confident in your own abilities, because you, as an individual, you're fucking there. Mm-hmm. It's now about leadership. We want to see you at the end.
Thank you, Steph.
Guard!
My mum was diagnosed with breast cancer when I was around 10. But she passed away when I was 13.
Keep doing what you're doing, number three. Stand by.
Go.
I didn't cry at the funeral. I literally held it in the whole day because I was just trying to get my head around the fact that I would never see her again and, you know, that was it. We didn't really talk about my mum's death at all. That's how we coped with it. We just, yeah, put a lid on it and just, that's it.
No, you have, you keep going.
Times are hard, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck me.
Everyone outside! Move it! 5 minutes outside!
Come on, let's go.
Get the wagon, go!
Tonight, the teams will be sent on the run for escape and evasion. But first, they face a two-stage task in teams, designed to drain their physical reserves.
How you doing, Justine?
I think I'm going to die of hypothermia before anything else.
Come on, boys. Positive, yeah. Let's bring it. Yeah, positive. Come on, positive.
Let's go!
Following their defeat in the previous task...
Move forward.
It's a chance for Justine to lead Team Alpha to victory.
Right, this next task is basically in your teams, you will pick a boat. Once you've picked a boat, you're going to follow the DS. It's as simple as that.
Let's go, move. I don't care how you do it. Get it above your head, drag it. This boat should not be touching the floor.
Each team must race over boggy terrain to a lock 2 miles away.
Two, one, go, one. Oh, shit.
Carrying a 95-kilo boat with an extra 20 kilos on their back.
Get this boat fucking moving up the hill.
Let's get moving!
Keep that pace. It's a steady pace. We're not going any faster than we need to.
Sean's team, Bravo, take an early lead.
Every foot we make, a step closer to the end, isn't it, eh?
Let's go, that's good. Driving number four.
I've always drifted and not put myself in that spotlight, just in case I get it wrong.
Left.
Come on, fuck! There's fucking ditches everywhere. Number four, you're supposed to be fucking guiding this.
Three, two, one, let's go.
Direct them and move them!
Because of my job role in school,
feel like a lot of people look up to me.
Organise them now!
So, I don't like the fact that I'm still scared of failing.
Take it off! Get it off! Push!
Keep going!
Push!
Wait.
Number three, take charge, lift the boat together as a team.
Okay, guys, we need to try and get underneath the boat a little bit more.
That's it.
Wait, on your shoulders, get it on your shoulders at the front.
That's it, get under. That's it, under, everybody. Get your bags underneath it.
Good.
That's it. Three, take charge, that's it. Come on then, organise. How are you going to get over that fence? Come on,
number four. First to the front. Got the end of the weight.
After a strong start.
Right, listen to me, one voice. We're going to lift it, we're going to go over that first section there.
Bravo have hit an obstacle.
Three, two, one, go.
Team Alpha catching you because you're like a bunch of fucking old women. Get a move on.
Over your head, just lift it now.
Small steps, guys.
Right, now number three, think how you're going to tackle that obstacle.
Get over, 16, get over!
Right, guys, come on, drag it through the shallow water.
Put it in your channel!
Come on, 18.
Good. Smart. Good.
By choosing to navigate the boat through the water instead of over the fence, Team Alpha overtake Team Bravo.
Team Alpha have gone past. You're twice the size of them. They've got more strength in their piss than you've got in your bodies. Drop it.
And win the race.
Fools versus Brain. And Brain won.
Now the recruits have been exhausted on land. The DS will push them further with a grueling open water task designed to push their bodies to near hypothermia.
Right, myself and the DS are going to give you a demonstration of how you rewrite these boats if they are capsized. So I suggest you pay attention to everything that myself and the DS do when we're in the water.
Operating in almost freezing water, the recruits must first capsize the boat.
Observe. For every situation, every environment, you will always do emergency drills.
Ready?
You're gonna turn the boat over to go through the drill. If, for instance, if you're in the water, the boat goes over into the dead of night, you're exhausted, you're tired, you're freezing cold, you're wet. You have to know exactly how to put that problem right immediately.
Keep watching.
Within seconds, if your drills and your equipment is not taken care of properly, you will go down with hypothermia.
One recruit must cling to the bottom. And once upright, retrieve the remaining members from the water. Justine's team are the first to go.
Ready? Everybody up.
Three, two, one.
Number seven, Lauren, has volunteered to take the more physically demanding role.
Wait.
Communicate.
Three, two, one.
Go!
Good effort!
Get me on.
Strong.
Right, you four, come down.
Good effort.
Next to go, a Team Bravo.
Four, time to shine.
Okay, two in the middle, take a step back. Left leg on.
Good effort, well done!
With the first round of the task over, the ice-cold temperature is taking its toll on Team Alpha.
Number three. I'd say number seven is struggling.
Yes, sir.
Operating in a cold environment is painful, it's hard.
Go! Fucking spring, warm up. Spring, warm up.
Some people will tolerate the cold longer than others. That's a fact.
Move, number seven, because you're going back in the water, number seven. Go. It's too much for you. You can give me your number.
But at some point, that cold will take control of you.
Motivate number seven.
It breaks down the best of people.
Get a grip of yourself. You're going back in there, number seven. If you don't want to go back in there, give me your number. Grab your Bergen, dress over to the side.
Seven. Oh, didn't see that coming.
I'm going to give it everything I've got. But I think that if you chip away at people, they do break. And I will know when I need to go.
Number seven, Lauren, has voluntarily withdrawn from the course. Now just seven recruits remain.
You are one person down. Do you understand me? Are you okay, number three?
Yes, stop.
Are you sure?
Yes, stop.
I'm going to do exactly the same drill with Bergens.
It is vital on a battlefield to have your equipment operationally ready at all times.
Attach your Bergens to the ringlets. Is there any winch on there?
We operate beyond the enemy lines. You can't afford not to have your shit together.
Breathe.
Number 10, Kieran, suggested strapping the Bergens onto the boat.
You ain't getting nowhere without being in a team, innit? You know? But, like, I'm not gonna be like, oh, I've got the bigger dick. I'm gonna lead, you know?
Okay, everybody, me on the side.
On the edge.
On the edge.
This is where it counts! This is where it matters!
But, okay. I don't know what it is.
On it.
I just have something inside me, you know? I feel like I can pull out the bag.
Three, two, one. No.
Go on, Justine. Go on, Justine, you can do it. You can do it, Justine.
Because I've had, like, quite a few life experiences for somebody my age, I think I definitely know myself really well.
Good girl, good girl.
If I did join the military, I would be able to cope with it. I wouldn't doubt myself.
OK, Justine?
OK. Yeah?
Well done!
Fucking good effort, M3. They're working really well as a team, I'm not.
As Team Alpha strapped their Bergens onto the boat, they kept their equipment at hand and have successfully completed the task.
Bergens at the front.
Are we tying them up or?
No, going off.
Go.
Pull that paddle out. Yeah, next one on, go. Two, one,
ready.
Give me a big ready. Connor and we'll tell you when we're going.
Three,
two, one,
go.
Fucking hell.
Fucking bags everywhere.
Bunch of clowns.
By failing to secure their Bergens, Team Bravo have failed the task.
Right, Team Bravo, come here. What the fuck happened there? Your Bergens were all over the place. If there was a massive sea state, it was at night, you'd be fucked.
Communication's key there, isn't it? Four, take charge of your fucking boat. You're the boat commander there.
Get in the wagons, go! Move it!
Okay, number four, get your team together, let's go! Lead from the front, number four!
Got nothing in me, boys. I'm gonna take my armband off, mate.
No, you're not.
It's okay. It's fine.
Quite frankly, look at me. I don't give a fuck right now. Look, I'm so, like, literally, like, this is the closest I've been to homeless, like, I think, ever.
Number four! Number four!
After failing to lead his team to success in the previous task, the DS want to find out why number four, Sean, isn't fulfilling his potential as a leader.
How are you finding this?
Tried to kick on today.
that were disappointed with the task.
You're a school teacher, right?
Staff.
Which is full of leadership, isn't it? So this should have been second nature to you. But it wasn't, was it? You seem to have lost complete confidence at the moment. What's took that away from you?
I just didn't think I took instructions on as good as I could have done.
Right. Growing up, where are you from?
Manchester staff. Rush on my side, which is quite a diverse community.
Good upbringing?
Our household wasn't great. It's not a great upbringing staff, no. My dad and my mother never got along. My mum just couldn't cope. And her way of dealing with it was to turn, you know, to drug abuse and that.
How old were you then when this was happening?
11 years old, 11, 12.
Right.
When my dad went away, my mum had a choice, and she made a choice, and she moved us away out the area to a predominantly white British environment, and immediately just didn't fit. Suffered racism for about 2 years, and I never spoke to anyone about it. I hated the colour of my skin, stuff. I just wanted to be like the rest of my friends, and there'd be times where I'd go home and look at the colour and ask myself why.
Yeah, I was born in the 60s. On my estate, there was only one other mixed-race family in the South.
Okay.
And I remember my dad getting spat at, getting shouted at, getting abused, especially my mother. There's a lot of unconscious bias and so on going around, but hopefully it's getting better.
Yeah.
What do you want to get out of this?
You know, I know what I could have been, but I don't know what I'm capable of doing.
We want to know who you are as well. But in order for us to do that, you have to give us 100%. All right? Grow with confidence. Prove to me that you really want to be here and you're going to go for it. Good!
As a kid, I was judged on the colour of my skin.
What the hell?
So it made me feel I'm not good enough. I remember getting home one day, got some bleach, poured the bleach down my arm, and I scrubbed for a good 10 minutes until it stung, until it burnt. At the time, that was where my head was at. I was trying so hard to fit in.
Just a chat, mate.
Yeah, mate, got grilled.
Before today?
Yeah. Over the years, I've learned to cope with any situation that I'm thrown into, and that's all down to growing up a lot faster than I should have done.
What day is it?
Friday, mate.
Oh, it's Friday, yeah.
5 o'clock. Start looking at menus now and just eat.
I'm so hungry.
We normally get pizzas and Indian.
The recruits don't know it yet, but they will soon embark on the escape and evasion stage of the course. But first, they have one last meal.
Guys, I just went into the mess and there's literally just like a line of apples.
Oh my God.
One for each of us.
One each. That's nuts.
The tea and coffee's gone.
Game started, boys.
Number four!
Having exhausted them physically, the DS will now apply mental pressure by seeing how the recruits react to potential contact with their loved ones.
Strength is important in the Special Forces. But just because you're strong physically doesn't mean you're strong mentally. No one really knows their true strength until they've been tested. As a Special Forces operator, your emotions are definitely heightened. You have to know when to bring them to the forefront, and you have to know when to control them.
You doing?
What's going on?
How are you?
Oh, mate.
Messages from home, everyone deals with them differently.
Today I was struggling, I was gonna come home. I was gonna come home, I thought I'd had enough, but I'm gonna push on, mate, and finish strong. It's about 48 hours.
Over it. What do you want?
For me, it's a distraction. I'd rather not know any sort of problems that I couldn't solve.
See you soon.
Daddy, love you.
Remy, please say daddy love you. Please say daddy love you. Bye.
Thank you,
Bubba.
Yeah. Right.
Thank
you.
See you
soon.
He found that really difficult. I don't think that's going to do him any good.
That's the right decision. Closes, that's his little box, boxed off. We need to know what type of people they are. Because if you have any distractions whatsoever, you won't make it through. Look, she's computing what's going on.
I'm quite good at, like, focusing on one thing and putting everything else to one side if that's what needs to be done. You just keep going and not let any of the other things get in the way. Because the minute you do, that's when you lose control.
Beyond her years.
She is beyond her years. She is going to make an awesome soldier.
I mean, look, we all channel into energy different ways, don't we? But
that's pushed me on. I needed that.
Yeah.
Did you get shot?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah.
No way.
Well done.
You're hard, not you.
Well done. You are hard, that. Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, yeah.
Was it good?
Pulled my eyes out.
Yeah. Oh, no.
On selection, you know that escape and evasion is coming, but you can never prepare for it. It is always still terrifying. It is the most exposing, intimidating situation you could ever be in. You have no idea what the enemy have got in store for you. The next phase is designed to push people to their limits, or what they perceive as their limits. It's where you prove to us as the DS that you've got what it takes.
To start the escape and evasion phase of selection.
You're to move as a team at all times. That's the edge of the forest, there's some outbuildings, and that is RV1.
Armed with just a compass and a map, each team must navigate their way to two separate RV points to meet agents who will direct them to an extraction point on the western shore of the island.
Right now, you're behind the lines, you're on the run, okay? You're gonna have to move fast, okay?
Both teams will be pursued by a hunter force.
We're gonna aim to get to RV1 as quickly as possible, but we're gonna stay off the road and move on from there.
Go, 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 go.
First to go are the all-male team Bravo, made up of number 16, Connor, number 9, DJ, number 19, Adam, and team leader, number 4, Sean.
A lot of alpha males here. Everyone's gonna bring ideas to the table. Ultimately, the decision lies with me. If we get captured, that's on my head, okay?
Cool.
Your final decision is mine.
Escape and evasion teamwork is crucial. You are in one of the most difficult situations that you as a team will find yourself in.
You need to get off this room now.
You're moving at night and you are cold.
Fuck.
Yep. It's horrendous. And you need to be able to rely upon one another and be there for each other.
Get further in. Trees there, we can get them trees.
If you hear anything, just stop.
Team Bravo decided to go off-road, which is safer, but slower. Back at base, the DS are following the team's progress.
Team Bravo are just slow. Team Alpha have moved off pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
They're moving, look, they're nearly at RV1. They are shifting.
Good pace, team. Good pace.
As soon as we get this RV, the better.
Along with her teammates, number 19, Tyler, and number 10, Kieran, Justine's team Alpha are way ahead after taking the faster but riskier road route.
So we're looking for a barn on our left, yeah?
Is this our barn?
Yeah.
We're at this point here.
Yeah.
So from here, we've got about a K and a half. Super important that we try to stay off the road.
Watch your face.
Half an hour behind Alpha, number 4, Sean, has led Team Bravo off-road.
Stay together.
So much point going right away in here.
People deserve a second chance. Path I'm on is the path I was meant to be on. The choices I've made were the choices I was meant to make. I still feel I've got more to achieve.
Anyone know where we actually are?
Team Bravo, slow as fuck. I can understand how they want to stay off the tracks because they could probably blend in more.
Yeah.
But they are too far away from that road.
Evergreen forest, that's gonna be pitch black through there.
Yeah.
Can I recommend we pick it up on a little bit of a jog when we get a bit of a straight?
There's lights in the distance.
Car, car, car. Car's coming.
He's bus, let's go, he's bus!
Get
the dogs, get the dogs!
Fuck, get down.
On the right side! Anybody see? Can you see anybody?
The hunter force are closing in.
Keep sweeping, keep sweeping. Let's keep them going. Okay, let's regroup. Let's regroup. Mount up. Ready to move again.
Is it gone?
There's still one more car back there.
Fuck's sake.
We shouldn't be walking on the road.
No, we're way quicker on the road.
She said stay off the road.
We can't be going off the road. We won't know where we're going.
We need to get up here. Higher ground, so we can see what comes. In both directions.
Shh, shh. Stop. Car, get down. Switch that fucking torch off. Torch off, torch off.
Having taken the more direct, but physical route, Team Alpha are now in close contact with the hunter force.
We shouldn't be stopping. We should just keep moving.
Get down.
On escape and evasion, you can't afford to fight, to disagree, to bicker. You have to work together, because if you don't, it will fall apart.
Right, seeing ducks here. Let's get over the hill.
No, no, they'll see us.
Come on.
Go, come on.
Come on, up the hill. Let's just go up the hill.
Fuck's sake. Don't go too far up away from the road. We need to be able to see it.
Right.
Single file, boys. Follow my lead. Where I go, you go, OK?
In the last half hour, Team Bravo have only moved 1 kilometre.
Follow my lead.
Yeah. Hey, we're going way off course.
Hey, listen, just stop questioning me. Just listen to me. Wherever I go, just go. I know what you're saying, but I know what I'm doing. Keep questioning me, mate. It's not going to help, is it?
Car. Drop. Car. Hold it there, hold it, hold. Saw some down there on the right side. Get the dogs, guys. Let's get the dogs down here. They're round here somewhere.
We'll have to run the second, boys. Keep going. Oh, we need to go. Boys, we've got to run. Boys.
Stay where you are! Stay
down! 3 hours into escape and evasion, Team Bravo are captured.
Team Bravo have been caught. I'm not surprised. So slow. Do you know what? They disappoint me a bit. Disappointing.
Stay where you are! There's weapons on you! Face down!
Next time.
Interrogation is designed to expose all of your demons.
Keep looking at me. Keep looking at me, Kieran.
It can be a very dark place to be.
Your fucking bonus won't come in because that fucking Nazi won't save you!